If love was a woman and hate was a man, I wonder if they would find each other attractive. Really, if both love and hate just walked into a bar, would they attract each other? Pay the cover charge, notice each other from afar, and just attack each other, despite the fact that opposites attract each other. I wonder if it would be like at first sight, and love came to hate's crib by the end of the night, and together they drank a whole bottle of Moscato, because that's love's favorite. So now love's a little tipsy, and soon her dress hits the floor, but hate says, "Wait, I've never made love before." So love stares at hate deep in the eyes and replies, "Baby, without you, there's no me. You do more than just make me. So stop hating and create me." I wonder if day is the mother of night, and the sun rises when the moon is tucked in tight, and the stars like the skies and harmonize sweet lullabies when night cries because he wants to play with the fireflies. So mother day reads night a bedtime story about the little engine that could, because that's his favorite. And as she reads each word, letter by letter, night calms down and slowly feels better and better, till his eyes become far too heavy to hold. So finally they close and night seems to be asleep. So mother day just enjoys the brief moment of relief, puts behind her the long hours she clocked in for the week, tries to sneak out and turn off the light, but all of a sudden night reopens his eyes, realizes that his day has just gone by. So then he cries, "Mama, could you please just stay with me? Because I'm scared of the dark." And mother day stares the night in the eyes and sighs and says, "Son, go to sleep and be a good night. There is no such thing as darkness, only the absence of light. Sleep tight." I wonder if pleasure and pain are like fraternal twin sister and a brother, because you know you can't really find one without feeling the other. And I wonder if the mother gets greed, and when she gave birth, pain came first, but about 3 minutes later, pleasure followed, and both babies cried and cried until their cries reached a certain level of intensity that became damn near impossible to tell the difference between the two. So growing up, pleasure wore red and pain wore blue, so that when greed got confused, she could tell who was who. So together they grew, and everywhere that pain went, pleasure was right around the corner, and everything that pleasure did, pain had to join her, till one day, for whatever reason, the pleasure was in a real bad mood, so pain came through and gave her a Reese's peanut butter cup as a favor. And she smiled, and they shared them together. See, since pain was so good, it made pleasure for her. But I wonder if good is the root of all evil. I mean, if God was here first, then who gave evil birth? Maybe all evil things really make good sense. Perhaps God created evil to prove that he exists. And I wonder if it was God's plan to make life this miracle mosaic of antithesis, and if he intentionally made grief the interval between two moments of joy. I wonder if it was God's plan to make peace the interlude between two wars, and if he purposely placed the thorn on every rose on earth so that only the most diligent picker will avoid the pricks and gather the flower. See, I bet it's no coincidence that every bee has a sting, yet cleverness consists in gathering the honey nevertheless. But I wonder why he always torments us by always placing the truth within a lie. Why a nigga can't win for losing? Why what goes up must come down? Why you can't taste victory until you eat defeat? But it's not importantly why weeping must endure for a night, as long as other things story coming in the morning. I don't care why. Whenever it rains, it pours. As long as I know that there's a rainbow on its way, so I want to know why creation only destroys as it grows on. And why everything wrong feels so damn right. But I guess that's what makes death so easy. It's a hard-ass night.